Hey, as a smart home junkie, you probably want to automate everything, right? Well, one thing that's been on my wish list for a while was automating the little door of my chicken coop. And guess what? I finally did it. Now I never have to get up early again just to open the coop. In this video, I'll show you exactly how I did it. Spoiler, you don't need to be super technical for this one. Let's do this! I've had chickens for a while now, and last summer I placed some fertilized eggs under one of my hens. She hatched 4 chicks, and it turned out that 2 of them were roosters. Beautiful animals, but not so great for the neighbors when they start crowing at sunrise. So every night I'd lock them up myself, and every morning I'd let them out again. That had to be easier, right? So I started looking for a way to automate that little door. I found some cool DIY projects, I'll link a few in the description, but I really didn't have time to build something from scratch. Instead, I wanted a ready-made solution that would also work with Home Assistant. On AliExpress, there are a bunch of automatic chicken doors, but most of them only work with their own controller. No Home Assistant support. Then I came across a Hex integration for the Omlet Auto Door. That looked perfect. So I reached out to Omlet and asked if they could send me one to test. They did, but they're not paying me for this video. Even though it's not a DIY project, I still want to show you how I installed the Omlet Auto Door and how I integrated it with Home Assistant. The smart Auto Door comes in a small box with just a few parts. There's a clear multilingual manual with links to video guides, the main control unit, which also has a light sensor, a few accessories for mounting, and of course the door itself, which is made of solid plastic, not some cheap, flimsy thing, but a sturdy, well-built chicken door. It fits both left opening and right opening coops. You can also get optional lighting and a power adapter. The light turns on before the door closes, which is a nice touch. By default it runs on batteries, but if you want to connect it to Home Assistant, you'll need the power adapter. Without that, it only works via Bluetooth, no Wi-Fi. Bluetooth works fine with the Omlet app, but I haven't tested whether Bluetooth alone connects to Home Assistant. Over Wi-Fi though, it works perfectly. If you have tested that, let me know in the comments. Installing the door into the frame is super simple. A few screws and you're done. Omlet also sells full chicken coops where this door fits right in, but you can easily mount it on your own coop too, on wood or wire mesh. I built my own wooden coop a while ago with a little door made from mesh. So first I had to remove that to make space for the Omlet Auto Door. Then I cleaned up a bit and started the installation. I marked where the door should go, drilled 4 holes, and mounted the frame with the included screws and wing nuts. After putting the front panel back in place, most of the job was done. Next up was connecting the main control panel. That was easy. I connected the inner light and the door to it. Now I should mention I have an essential tremor, so my hands shake a bit, but even with that the setup was totally doable. So it's accessible even if you're not super handy. The light screws onto the inside of the coop, the controller slides neatly onto its bracket, and once you plug in the adapter, you're good to go. You can control it manually with Alexa, Google Assistant, Home Assistant or the Omlet app. The Omlet app is really simple. One button to open or close the door, one button to turn the light on or off, and a small lock that shows what happened recently. In the settings, you can choose to use the light sensor and set at what brightness the door should open or close. You can also add a delay if you want. Or you can skip the light sensor entirely and go by time schedule or switch everything to manual control. Now, here's the thing. I've got a rooster and I don't want him waking me or my neighbors up too early. So he's only allowed outside after 9 a.m. But in the evening, I still want the door to close automatically based on the light level. Unfortunately, you can't combine those two settings in the app. Luckily, I use Home Assistant, so I solved it with a simple automation. That's why my app is set to manual mode, and I'll show you how that works in a second. You can also tweak things like power saving settings, but since I use the adapter, I didn't need to touch that. If you use batteries, you should get about 2 or 3 months of runtime. You can check light levels, Wi-Fi strength and update firmware right from the app too. Pretty handy. Out of the box, the Omlet Auto Door works great, but I wanted a bit more control. There's a custom Home Assistant integration you can install through Hacks. If you don't have Hacks installed yet, check out my other video on that, links in the description. The integration is called Omlet Smart Coop and it gives you everything you could possibly need. You just create an API key in the Omlet developer console, it's literally one click, and then paste that into Home Assistant when you add the integration. Once connected, you'll see a cover switch to open and close the door, a light switch and sensors for battery, door, light and Wi-Fi. You can even adjust all your settings directly in Home Assistant. Now, this is where the fun starts, because here I can open the door at a fixed time and close it based on light level. I can even use my own outdoor light sensor for that. So here's the automation I created. It has three triggers. Two time-based ones for when the door should open, both set to 9 a.m. for now. And one for closing, which triggers my outdoor light sensor reads below 125 lux for 10 minutes. If it's an open trigger, the door opens. If it's a closed trigger and it's after 4 p.m, the light inside turns on first. Then 5 minutes later, the door closes and finally the light turns off again. That extra 4 p.m. checks make sure it doesn't close too early on cloudy days. I've been running this for a week now and it works flawlessly. I can sleep on weekends, the door closes automatically at night, my neighbors are happy and no predators can sneak in. I'm happy. If you want this door yourself, there's a link in the description. Without the light it's about 210 euros and with the light it's 240 euros. Building your own is cheaper, but you'll need more technical know-how. If you want a plug-and-play solution, this is a really solid choice. Thanks again for watching and a big thank you to everyone who supports me monthly. Without you, this channel wouldn't still exist. If you find my videos helpful, consider supporting me on Patreon, Ko-fi or by becoming a paid channel member. All the links are down below and don't forget to like, subscribe and leave a comment. It really helps me out. See you soon. Bye bye. And film seating thing. But a sturdy, one quick click. You just